Hello friends, this is Menak from Civil Center, and today we are going to discuss about one of our consultancy projects. The client name was Mr. Parmanjay Sao. The location of the project was Bhubaneswar, and it was basically a G+1 residential building in which we did all the consultancy works, starting from your architectural planning, structural drawing, estimation, 3D exterior views, interior drawings of all the individual rooms. So friends, I'm going to take you through all the consultancy works which I had mentioned of this building having built up area of around 1000 square feet. So let us see our consultancy works of this building.
So firstly, we'll have a look at our ground floor plan. This is our ground floor plan, and we'll look at it in detail. So this ground floor plan has a built up area of 1037 square feet, as I had mentioned earlier. And as you can see here, the elements plot is little curved from this portion, so the setback provided is around 2 feet in the rear side and 2 feet in the left side and 4 feet in the front side. So as you can see here, the portico, we have portico, and after that portico we have a veranda, and it can be also used as a sit out, and there is a decoration area here. After that we have a drawing room, quarter turn staircase, toilet, bedroom, dining room and kitchen. So these are the elements which we have in our ground floor plan. And in the first floor plan also, as you can see here, there are some balconies in the front portion, and we also have a balcony in the right portion in the master bedroom. So there we have a master bedroom, kitchen, dining, toilet, a living area, and another bedroom with attached toilet here. And we have a puja room here along with a seat out area. So these are the elements of the first floor plan along with the furniture layout, as you can see here. So these were the ground floor plan and first floor plan. So this is the terrace plan mentioning the slopes for drainage of rainwater, as you can see here. So this is a structural drawing of the building. Now let us discuss about the components of the structural drawing. In this structural drawing, we have the foundation layout, foundation schedule, as well as the plinth beam layout, and also the schedule of the plinth beam and the schedule of footing, beam column layout, and schedule of roof beam, and also schedule of columns. So these were the schedules and layouts, and we also have longitudinal sections of beams, plinth beams, roof beams, along with the cross section as well, as you can see here. And we have the section of our slab. We have the foundation sections. So we have given pile foundation in this project. So as you can see here, this is a drawing of the pile cap along with the pile. So as you can see here, this is a pile here, and we have provided two types of piles here, pile caps, and we have provided two types of pile caps here, that is one 3 pile cap and another 2 pile cap. So this was our structural drawing. We will now discuss the staircase structural drawing which we have made separately. This was the quarter turn staircase which I had shown in the architectural plan. And this is the rise and tread. We have cut a section here, and you can also see the reinforcement details of the staircase. So this is the structural drawing of the staircase, 3D exterior of the building, and this is our garage portion which can be used for the parking of the four wheelers, and this is our ground floor, and this is our first floor. We have also given the color codes of the exterior colors which have been used in our model. After the 3D drawings has been done, the contractor or the laborers which will construct the building will have to know all the levels and all the thickness and the distance between the grooves and all the details in the 3D exteriors. So for that, we also provide the elevations. As you can see here, this is the elevation of the 3D drawing. We'll also move towards the section, and from here you can determine or check the levels of various things like lintel level of the door and the floor to floor heights, thickness of the slabs, thickness of brickworks, and everything you can check from this section. So this was the section in which headroom is also included, and after that we'll move towards our estimate. So in estimate portion, we determine the quantity of all the materials which are going to be used in the project, and as per that we also give the cost of the project. So if you take the estimate from us, you will get an idea about the construction cost of the building. So since this estimate is detailed, so we'll get close to the accurate price of your building so that you can plan your expenses accordingly. So the estimate, as you can see, the quantity of piling work that is calculated in running meter, and then the earthwork, sand filling, PCC, plain cement, concrete, which is given below trim beam and foundation, and the RCC work, reinforced concrete work for columns, beams, slabs, staircases, or the steel work. And you can see the kg of steel in this unit in this project. The masonry works, which is the bricks, number of bricks, or fly ash brick or double AC block, whichever you can use in the project. Quantity of the bricks in various levels in the superstructure, as well as below the plinth level in the periphery walls, everything we can calculate here. And the plastering works. So the plastering works are of various types. You can have the plastering works of grooves, you can have the plastering works of the exterior, and you can have the plastering works of roof as well as building interior. So these are the plastering works as well as the punning, which is required in some areas. So everything we can calculate here. So this is our estimate. So friends, we saw the consultancy works of these projects, which included architectural plan, structural drawing, 3D exterior, and then estimate. So this was the estimate for the core house part. Now we'll move towards our interior works. So we'll view the images of the interior which we have made. So first we'll have a look of the interior view of a bedroom here. As you can see, this was the bedroom of the ground floor. As you can see here, we have given cupboards here. We have the false ceiling along with lights, LED lights, as you can see here. And we have also given the elements, that is your fan, AC, bed, king size, and then your cupboards here. And there are other views of the bedroom as well. As you can see, this is the other view of the bedroom in which this cupboards is visible properly. As you can see, this is the dressing table as well. We have a window behind the bed. So this was the interior drawing of the bedroom. And now moving on, this is the staircase. So the type of staircase structurally used here is the tread type staircase. As you can see here, this is the tread type staircase, and it's giving a beautiful look to the building. So it's a staircase, and in this portion you can also use for sit outs, design of the walls, as you can see. So in front of the staircase we have kept a sofa, and you can see a window here, and you can see a center table here. So this is the design of the living area in front of the staircase. So this image is another view of the interior of the drawing room. Let us show you in the plan which we had discussed here. We had seen the 3D image of this staircase first, and then we had also seen the image of this drawing room, and we are seeing now another view of this interior. And earlier we had seen the interior of this bedroom as well, including the cupboards and all. And moving on, this is the decoration area. As you can see here, this is this portion, the decoration area in the interior. So next we have the interior of the kitchen. So we have a kitchen here whose interior we have done here. So this is the interior image of the kitchen. As you can see, the various elements here along with the false ceiling and the wall hangings as well. So this was our interior works of the project. So we have discussed about the total consultancy works which we have done here, from architectural planning, structural drawing, estimate, 3D exterior views, as well as 3D interior views of some components of the building. So friends, that's all for today's video. If you want any consultancy works from us or any services from us in the field of architectural planning, structural drawing, 3D exterior works, 3D interior designs, or estimate, you can contact us. You can directly email us at enquiry@civilcenter.in. As you can see here, this is our email ID, enquiry@civilcenter.in. You can directly drop an email and our team will get in touch with you. So see you guys. Bye-bye.